In this video, we will discuss ketogenic diet, which is a high-fat, low-carbohydrate nutritional approach that recently has gained enormous popularity for weight loss. In this video, we'll explain what is ketogenic diet, how it works biochemically, its potential benefits, and what the science says. Let's begin. There are four major steps in ketogenic diet. First of all, the essential feature of ketogenic diet is carbohydrate restriction. Without reduction in carbohydrates intake, this diet does not work, and we'll see why. Restriction of carbs leads to mobilization of fat tissue. After this, fatty acids will undergo beta oxidation, which will provide substrates for ketogenesis. So, let's briefly illustrate this, just to understand the logic behind this diet. So, in our blood, we have glucose, which is the most valuable source of energy in our organism. Practically every cell in our body uses glucose as source of energy. But what happens in conditions as fasting or with decrease in carbohydrates intake? Because in these circumstances, blood glucose level decreases. So how organism fixes the problem? During fasting, or when carbohydrate intake is severely restricted, blood glucose level drops. The body senses this decrease in glucose and reduces insulin secretion while increasing glucagon secretion. In our body, we have adipose tissue, which consists mostly of triacylglycerols. Proglucagon state activate lipolysis through activation of hormone-sensitive lipase. As a result of breakdown of triacylglycerols, massive amount of free fatty acids released into the bloodstream. In the blood, free fatty acids bind to albumin, and in form of albumin complexes, they are delivered to liver tissue. In the liver, free fatty acids undergo beta oxidation. This process takes place in the mitochondria. Beta oxidation of fatty acids results in production of large quantities of acetyl-CoA. After this, most of acetyl-CoA molecules go into the Krebs cycle. And important that the activity of the Krebs cycle depends on the amount of its intermediate metabolites. And one of those metabolites is oxaloacetate. And the amount of oxaloacetate is proportionate to the amount of glucose in the tissue. So, guess what? During fasting, for example, glucose level decreases, which causes decrease in oxaloacetate level. And with decrease in oxaloacetate, the function of the Krebs cycle decreases. So now, liver cannot use all of these acetyl-CoA molecules in the Krebs cycle. Acetyl-CoA begin to accumulate, and we have to find the alternative pathway. And it's a moment when liver begins to produce ketone bodies. Initially, from acetyl-CoA, liver produces acetoacetyl-CoA. After this, a specific rate-limiting enzyme called HMG-CoA synthase converts acetoacetyl-CoA to HMG-CoA. The activity of this enzyme dramatically increases during fasting and starvation. From HMG-CoA, liver produces acetoacetate, which is the first ketone body. From acetoacetate, we can produce beta-hydroxybutyrate, or by decarboxylation, we can produce acetone. Acetone is a totally useless ketone body, which we will excrete from the organism by the lungs. In some people, it can cause fruity odor. But oxaloacetate and beta-hydroxybutyrate are useful substances. They go into the brain, heart, and muscle tissues, where they serve as a backup fuel in the absence of glucose. In this pathway of ketogenic diet, the key reaction is activation of lipolysis by glucagon, because exactly high glucagon level allow us to break down fat tissue. But we also should understand that this reaction will be possible only if our carbohydrate intake will be extremely low. So, person on ketogenic diet should permanently avoid carbohydrate-rich products, including bread, milk, cookies, and so on. So this diet requires self-discipline and total commitment. Here we can see the ratio for a standard 2000 kilocalories keto diet. What is important here are the proportions. As we see, fat should consist 70% of daily calories, simply because we will utilize all the fat that we eat for production of ketone bodies. Proteins should consist 20% of daily calories. The logic is that we cannot eat a lot of proteins, because from some amino acids in proteins we can make glucose, but we cannot cut off proteins because in this case we will lose muscle mass. So proteins should be present. And the most important feature is limited amount of carbs. Mostly it should be vegetables and fruits with limited amount of starch, because starch is basically glucose, and with glucose ketogenic diet does not work. Also, you cannot eat fructose, because from fructose we can make glucose. So honey, for example, also does not work. Here you can see a standard food composition for a person on ketogenic diet. So as you can see, it's not an easy diet to follow. It requires total commitment and self-discipline. Well, how effective is ketogenic diet? And the answer is that it's one of the most effective diets in our possession. We can define three stages of ketogenic diet. Initially, it's rapid weight loss, which typically lasts for 1 or 2 weeks. At this stage, most people lose up to 2 kilograms per week. The reason is drop in water weight due to the glycogen depletion. So let's explain this. Recall that glucose is a very hydrophilic substance, because glucose has a lot of hydroxyl groups, and hydroxyl groups attract water. Glycogen is a number of glucose molecules connected with each other, and each glucose molecule carries water. So, once you decrease carbohydrates intake, organism begin to use the storage form of glucose in form of glycogen. And during the first week, step by step, the amount of glycogen in the organism will progressively decrease. And with glycogen, the excess water decreases, which leads to a rapid drop in weight. Because, for example, triacylglycerols, from which our fat tissue is composed, do not attract water. And because of this, they are way lighter substances. The next phase is a steady loss phase, where most people lose approximately 0.5 kilogram per week. Weight loss will vary based on individual metabolism, but important that ketogenic diet, according to randomized studies, is more effective than the standard low-fat diet, and in the long term, person will continue to lose weight, but you should be aware of plateau phase, which occurs due to a metabolic adaptation. If we compare ketogenic diet with a standard low-fat diet, in both early and late phases, ketogenic diet is significantly more efficient. But there are also a few important concepts that you should be aware of. First of all, ketogenic diet is a very strict diet, and sometimes people can experience fatigue, headaches, and irritability. But usually it lasts for over 2 weeks. Then adaptation occurs. Also, you have to check electrolytes level at least once a month, because ketogenic diet is associated with decrease in sodium, potassium, and magnesium levels. Adequate hydration is also plays important part. For example, 70 kg patient on ketogenic diet should drink at least 4 liters of water daily. And in addition to this, you have to check lipid profile, because ketogenic diet can cause elevation of cholesterol and low density lipoprotein level.